Relax My Dog. My name is Leah and this is Milo, and we upload on this channel every single week. Today we're going to be talking about top tips when wanting to train your dog. Now, if you have seen some of our previous videos, you will know that Milo is a border collie, and border collies are known to be extremely clever and smart. So for Milo, it didn't really take that long for him to learn certain tricks such as sit, lie down, speak, walk, paw, that sort of thing. You're quite good at all them tricks, which I'll put in some clips to show with you guys. Milo, come here. Sit. Good boy. Lie down. Speak. Paw. Other paw. Good boy. Other paw. Good boy. But today I'm going to talk to you about a few tips that I used when wanting to train Milo, or that you might find quite useful. So the first tip, and I think most important, is to be patient with your dog. Like I said, some dogs are a lot more clever and they can take in things a lot quicker than other breeds. So just be patient with your dog and make sure that you're quite consistent with what you're doing, which again fits in with another tip. And that is to be consistent. Make sure that everybody in your family knows what sort of rules you're going to have in the house. Because if you tell a dog that he isn't allowed on the sofa and then somebody else lets him on the sofa, it's going to confuse the dog a lot and it's going to be very, very inconsistent and maybe not efficient when wanting to train your dog. But as well, linking in with this, it's also important to give the dog a lot of attention. And as opposed to just acknowledging the mistakes that your dog is doing, if they don't do a trick right or they're just completely ignoring you, don't just acknowledge the positives. And when they do it, make sure you are reinforcing little things that they do relating to the trick that you want to teach them. But as well, sticking with that, don't confuse them by treating them to things that aren't necessarily related to the trick. For example, if Milo were to move or shift one of his paws, when I asked for paw initially, I would normally give him a treat for that because he's showing that he does acknowledge that what he is doing. And then when he does give eventually a paw, give him a lot of encouragement and a lot more praise than you would do necessarily. Now, another great tip is to not compare your dog with any other dogs. For instance, if another friend's dog takes a trick a lot quicker than your dog, don't be afraid to keep going and be persistent with your dog, because eventually they will learn it, as long as you are giving them the positive reinforcement to encourage them to learn a particular trick. However, the last resort could be to take your dog to dog training classes. There you will meet professionals that can help you train your dog and give you a little bit more encouragement, and let them be in an environment where every single dog is learning their particular trick, which might help the dog feel a little bit more encouraged and a little bit more relaxed, because I can imagine it'd be quite intense for a dog to learn a particular trick, especially in the initial stages when they don't really recognize anything. It can be quite distressing, and you want to keep your dog relaxed during that process as well. So make sure that you're doing sort of short spurts as opposed to a really, really long day of learning a particular trick. Make sure you're doing maybe 10 minutes per day to allow them to learn the trick thoroughly. Now, it's up to you how you would like to train your dog, whether you want to train them just by giving them a stroke when they've done something right, or if you want to use more positive reinforcement by giving them a reward, whether that is a treat or a particular toy or anything that you think will be beneficial to your dog. We actually used treats with Milo, just little tiny ones like the training treats that you can get. We don't normally give him like a proper big biscuit initially, but that would help him know that he was doing something right. Don't overload your dog up on treats, because then they might feel a little bit sick and you don't really want that, especially when you've got so far in the training process. And that is it from us. Hopefully you have taught your dog some particular tricks. Let me know them down below what your dog can do, and also if you have any specific tips that you think you can help any other people watching this video. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up to let us know that you enjoyed it, and also comment down below, like I say, any of your specific tricks that you have taught your dog. And also don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already to the Relax My Dog channel, and we will see you all in our next video. Bye! Say bye! One, two, three, four, five, six, get it!